I'm too young to feel so numb, 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 numb. You could be the one to make me feel something.
Breaking up with me because I'm too blonde?
Well, then, no, this was a guess. Sit down now, had a hard glass. Seems like the real thing's hard to find.
It's just not the right time.
Yeah.
This book is terrifying and genuinely made me viscerally uncomfortable while reading. And for those reasons, I recommend everyone to read this, especially those who consider themselves to be allies and supporters of Black Lives and the Black Lives Matter movement. And here's why. This story centers two Black students, Chimaka and Devon, as they are the only two Black students at a private school called Nivius Academy. They've both done really well so far in all their years of high school, and both are in the running to be valedictorian at the end of senior year. However, with the start of their senior year, things feel really different when they get back to school. And soon enough, an anonymous texter starts sending out deep, dark secrets about both of these students, seemingly targeting just the two of them. What starts as maybe a joke or a prank turns into something really, really dangerous that not only threatens them getting into the colleges they've been working so hard for, but also their lives, their safety, and the safety of the friends and family around them. Some of the things that happen to these two students in this book are genuinely sickening, to the point where I felt nauseous while reading at some points. And while I understand that that may be difficult for some readers to feel viscerally uncomfortable while they're reading something, I am of the belief that if Black people have to live these types of experiences on a daily basis, the least we can do as allies and supporters of Black lives is to read about something that makes us uncomfortable, that makes us feel that inescapable discomfort and fear that Black people face every day. Now, of course, this is a work of fiction, so while the things that happen in this book may be a little bit of an exaggeration on stuff that may normally happen, that doesn't mean that they are false in any way. Obviously, I won't be the first to say that it's hard to believe that a human being could do something like that to another human being, but people target Black people purely because of their skin tone. Farida Abike-Imide also mentioned at the end of this book that while she was attending university, she was one of the only people of color on her campus and felt these feelings of discomfort, felt eyes on her purely because of her skin tone. So again, while some of these things in the story may feel a little far-fetched, they are lived and real experiences that are important to read about and talk about. This book is also just so beautifully written and really compelling and super fast-paced, and these characters are so well-crafted that that is what makes it so terrifying to read about some of these experiences, because you feel that you know these characters over time. I advise anyone interested in reading this book to check trigger warnings before doing so. There are some very heavy topics covered in this story, and it's important to know what you're going into before you read it. With all that being said, I cannot recommend this book enough. Farida Abike-Imide takes these terrifying things that happen to these students and show that there is still hope at the end of these stories. I'll also be linking some content creators down below who have done some amazing own voice reviews that I think you should check out as well before you read. Thank you.
I don't even know where to start, but I can play the part.
We say we're friends, but I'm catching you across the room. That makes no sense, cause we're fighting over what we do. And there's no way that I'll end up being with you. But friends don't look at friends that way.
I was already sad. Why did I play this song?
I was running through the six with my walls.
Yeah. I was running through the six with my walls.
Oh my God! Oh my God.
You know who? I'd want you to feel cut off from everyone else. Because if it's just you alone, you're not as much of a threat.